I'm going to be doing another Snapchat Q&A, so submit your video questions.
Okay, guys, final thing I do before going to bed, I'm going to answer some Snapchat questions that you guys sent in a couple weeks ago.
My question is, how do you overcome the graphic nature of the industry? Thanks.
So I personally don't mind it at all. In fact, I'm kind of fascinated by all of that. But I understand not everyone's enthused by the blood and the guts and everything. And that doesn't mean you won't make a good doctor, though. There are many fields within medicine where you don't have to deal with a ton of bodily fluids. For instance, I shadowed a nephrologist in his private practice where he didn't have to open anyone up or deal with the so-called graphic stuff. And same thing with my psych rotation. You might find it surprising that some medical students pass out in their first surgery or in their first anatomy dissection lab, and that's totally okay. You either get used to it or you pick a specialty where you don't have to deal with that every day.
In medical school, how long do each rotation last, like surgical, pediatrics?
So it depends on the school. At my school, you have 8 weeks for medicine, 8 weeks for surgery, and most of the other rotations are 6 weeks long. So psychiatry, pediatrics, OB-GYN, family medicine are all 6 weeks long. We also have 5 weeks for elective where you can pick what you want to do. And you have 3 weeks for neuro. I'm going to be doing 5 weeks of emergency medicine. Actually, I think it's going to be 4 weeks of emergency medicine and 1 week of...
Hi, I just wanted to ask you if you have any tips on studying anatomy, because there are a lot of Latin names. It's just, oh my God.
I think the best tip to keep in mind is that not all structures are equally important. There are certain structures that are more prone to injury or are more relevant to certain disease processes, and those are the ones that will be most likely tested. That said, I think the best way to prepare for anatomy practicals and exam is to see the structures in person as much as possible. So that means going into the cadaver lab as many times as you can, and make sure you go in with a partner so you guys can quiz each other. Another way to study is to use a 3D anatomy app or a textbook to simulate a real cadaver if you can't go in. The app that I recommend is called Essential Anatomy from Apple App Store. And the textbook that I recommend is called Color Atlas of Anatomy Textbook. This textbook actually has actual photographs of dissected cadavers, so it's a good substitution for when you can actually go into the lab yourself.
Hey girl, my question is, besides studying and YouTube, what groups are you involved with on campus? Interest groups, extracurriculars, that stuff?
As third year and fourth year med students, we don't do as much extracurricular stuff on campus because we spend most of our time at the hospital. Most of the clubs and organizations are geared towards the first 2 years of med school, so I'll talk about what I did during the first 2 years. I did a cappella group. I'm in between alto and soprano, so I sang in both parts depending on where they needed me. I also did a student mentor thing where I met with a pre-med student regularly and gave advice on how to be a successful med student candidate. And my mentee actually just started his first year of med student, so I'm really happy about that. Another extracurricular activity I did is the school merchandise. So I was involved in a team of people who designed and sold school merchandise like wine glasses, sweatshirts, sweatpants. Another thing I did was I did research with the sports medicine department at my school during my summer between first and second year.
Hey Jamie, I just wanted to know, as a first year medical student, is it even worth worrying about step one and starting to study, looking through first aid and everything?
So the short answer to this question is no, but here's a long answer. I think it's really important to lay a strong foundation so that you don't have to teach yourself an entire concept from scratch come studying time. That said, for me, I felt like focusing on my schoolwork was enough to lay that strong foundation. I barely even thought about step one during my first year. And I think at this point in your medical education, I don't think you learn enough of the pathophysiology to be able to answer step one questions. I would definitely recommend doing some questions starting your second year as you learn each subject, though. During the first year, I will focus on learning the physiology and biochem if that's part of your first year curriculum. I really think the best thing to do during first year is to establish good study system and or study group that you can trust. And really just enjoy spending time with your classmates and figure out a good daily routine that can set you up for success for the rest of your medical school career.
Have you ever faced failure in med school or in high school? And if you have, then how did you deal with it?
So thankfully, I haven't failed anything yet. But as I go through med school, I face that fear of failure pretty much before every exam or before any evaluation that I receive. I give myself like a little pep talk before, like pretty frequently. I tell myself that I've done everything I needed to do and that I just have to trust myself to perform the way I've been practicing. And I know exam anxiety is a real thing and it can affect the way you perform on a test. So going in with the confidence that you're capable of doing well can really make a big difference. I think the best way to deal with failure is to directly address why you failed. Most professors and upperclassmen that I've talked to are always eager to help you succeed in med school. So if you failed, ask yourself, did I do enough practice questions? Did I know enough of the high yield materials? If you don't know what's high yield and what's not, are you meeting with your TAs or professors on a regular basis to get a sense of what they think is important for you to know? I personally think the best way to deal with failure is to accept your mistakes and fix them for the next time.
I'm wondering, how many hours did you study daily and how long did it take you to get used to the fast pace and heavy workload of med school?
So I'll answer this question from the perspective of a first or second year med student, because that's when the bulk of your sit down studies are done. To tell you the truth, I feel like I study so much more in undergrad compared to now. But also, I think I'm way more efficient at studying now than I was in undergrad. I used to do a lot of like all-nighters and intense cramming in undergrad. In med school, I still felt like there were days when I was like cramming, but I would be doing it like 2 weeks before the exam. So I don't know if that's really considered cramming. I don't know. There's just a lot of things to know in med school. But one thing I do differently in med school compared to undergrad is now I stay on top of my study material every single day. I never ever do all-nighters because I just feel like it just throws my whole schedule for a few days. And now that I'm older, it's not as easy to recover from that. But I think overall, there's just more material to study, but you adapt your study skills to be able to handle them better. So somehow it became more manageable, at least for me. So I'm gonna end the vlog here. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope I answered some of your questions. I'll continue to answer some of the leftover Snapchat questions in future vlogs, or maybe I'll make a dedicated video for it. I'm not sure yet. Like and subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.